Hello everyone and welcome back to A Mile in My Stilettos. I'm excited because today I'm going to be telling you guys how I did these knotless braids without blowing out my hair, without straightening my hair, without having a good grip game, without using the feed-in method, any of that. I simply used a crochet knotless method, and this hair was provided to me by Young Fur Hair. This is the company, you can see right there. And this is 26 inch ombre hair. This hair is cute, you guys. All right, you guys, so let's jump into this tutorial. So what you see me doing here is going ahead and I'm making little braids all over my hair. And this is going to be the base or the foundation for the crochet because I am doing them as individual crochet. This actually didn't take too long, and you see me dipping my finger down and putting something on my hair. That is the edge control that I use on my hair, and making sure that I have a good amount of this and have my hair combed out with it is what allows me to not have to straighten or blow dry my hair for this style. Also, I ended up doing braids, not just two strand twists, because I wanted to make sure that I had a really good foundation for when I was creating this crochet look. So that's why I did braids and not just twist. Now, when I part my hair in between each section, I make sure that I add some edge control, and I do this because it helps make sure that the parts stay nice and sleek and clearly separated. And so I add edge control to both sides of the part, and then I'm just going to continue to part and section and make individual plaits, all of that. And like I said, this part wasn't actually too time consuming, but to make sure that your parts are straight, you don't want to do this when you're in like a rush. Also, one of the things that I did was I used the brick pattern for the back of my hair. So basically that means that I didn't do the parts evenly in the back so that they would be able to lay more smoothly. But when I got up to the front, I made sure that I did the parts basically straight across and more evenly. So yeah. That's what I'm going to be doing here. So I have it all sped up and everything for you guys. But we'll be moving on to the next part of the video in just a moment. Alrighty, you guys. So for the next part of this process, you're going to take your crochet needle. And this hair actually came with a crochet needle and the purple clip that you see in my hair. So they give you a little couple little bonuses here. But you're going to crochet the hair by sliding it all the way through. You're gonna pull it all the way through, and then you're going to take the hair and you're going to start braiding it into a regular braid like you traditionally would with the three different strands of hair. And I have it slowed down so that you can see how I separate that other piece of hair and add it to my natural hair. And then you're going to just continue down the rest of the braid like you normally would when you're just braiding. And it's important to pull your fingers through the hair to alleviate it getting tangled as you're doing the braiding process. So this is the hair. Honestly, it came with several of these in the pack, and I had plenty of hair. I'm gonna put all the details in the description box, but I love this ombre color. I love the silky softness of this hair. It's not rough like your typical kinkalon hair. It wasn't tangling up while I was using it or anything like that. So they can be found on Amazon. Again, the link will be in the description box. I only used three of these to do my entire head. So it comes down to my butt, and that's without feeding in and extending the hair to make it longer or anything like that. And yeah, I just had a really good experience with the hair. I would definitely recommend it if you're looking for this ombre color. It is beautiful, and I want to say they have black as well. Again, the link will be in the description box so you can check out more concerning the hair, but I definitely would recommend them. and then I'm going to show you me braiding the hair. Once again, you just pull it through with the crochet needle, pulling only one end of the hair all the way through so that you have your three legs for your braid. And then you're going to continue to braid down like you normally would. And this is a pretty repetitive process, so I am not going to show you me doing my entire head. I think that you get the gist. If not, you can definitely rewind it so you can see that part again. Don't forget to give a thumbs up and like this tutorial if you found it to be helpful, and subscribe to the channel so I can bring you more tutorials like this.
So I have four of those packs left, and listen, I could do a whole nother set of knotless box braids. I definitely love these knotless box braids. I love the fact that they are light and airy. They were easy to do. My hair has never felt so light having box braids. It really has never felt this light having box braids. So if sometimes you're nervous about getting box braids because how heavy it is for your neck and you're trying to sleep and all that, I definitely would recommend this knotless method, again, because I didn't have to blow out my hair or anything like that. I don't believe in doing damaging things to your hair to have a protective style. That doesn't make sense to me. So if you're looking for a way to have some knotless braids without damaging your hair, having to straighten it out or anything like that, this could be the way to go. And also, if you're not that good at gripping to the root, this is a great way to go. And yeah, there's no knots, nice and flat. And these are a little bit older at this point. I put them in, but yeah, I didn't film this part of the video until later. So they're a little older at this point, but still holding up well. They're not perfect. I definitely can get better at this, but you know, for me, not having to pay, you know, all this money to get them done because people will charge you a lot for knotless box braids, I'm happy with it. I'm getting compliments on them. And I hope you don't forget to subscribe to the channel if you love getting beauty tutorials, hair tutorials, lifestyle tips, all that kind of stuff. Listen, it's a whole life over here in the Mile High Club. So make sure you get down with your girl, and I'll see you next time.